How do you recover? The technology that's necessary to do that is a combination of backup and archiving. So the way you would go about preserving data is somewhat different to how you might do in a non-ransomware world, where it's just a simple backup and a simple recovery. In this case, ransomware, backing up the ransomware, not useful. Going back in time until the ransomware is not there, not that easy, because you have to keep a lot of backup to make that work. The way we think about that is continuous data protection, where changes to files are shipped to a read-only environment. No overwrite takes place. In other words, that environment keeps all variants of those files, and recovery is available through a point-in-time indicator where you can say, I want my desktop restored to this state at this time, because that was the beginning of the ransomware process. But what you can't do is replicate the damage to another environment and hope to recover it. You need to have a way of preserving all of the changes to all of the data over time. I think there's a convergence at Mimecast which is very useful for ransomware defense. That is covering things like prevention, so the security layer that's necessary to stop ransomware infection. Quite unique to us in terms of sophistication is the continuity element. That is the ability to continue to function through apps and through web apps during an incident. Can I access my data? Can I find important files? Mimecast has a significant proportion of those already, even without things like drive sync and various other backup systems. And we have that data because of our archives, because of our significant data storage environments for compliance archiving. Those compliance archives contain a high proportion of the data that end users use or need on a daily basis. And it's fairly straightforward for us to allow access to that data during the lockdown period.